So we're on our way to get a side-by-side, and I wanted to show you guys the other day. I had that F-150, and on the interstate running about 80 mile an hour, 79 to 81, the F-150 with 373s would run at about 2,000 to 2,100 RPM. Now, I've got a trailer behind me that weighs about 3,000 pounds, and I don't ever see it getting over 16 to 1,700 RPM. It just stays in 10th. We've been running 79 mile an hour. It's just crazy how much difference it is with this towing running at that low of an RPM in comparison to the F-150 hybrid running at about 21 to 2400 RPM with no load to it. And we're going to see what our fuel mileage is going down here to pick this up and coming back. This is a 2020 F-250 with 331 gears, 10-speed transmission. There's bears down here. I absolutely love going through these mountains and driving up and down these hills in Tennessee. Hold on a minute, little man. Right now I'm getting 17.7 at 106.9 miles. And we'll see what we're getting when we get to the dealership. But you can just see, we've been going downhill forever. But it just up and down, up and down. What was you saying, little man?
That bear was in town unless it came from here.
It probably did. You think it took the highway or went through the woods?
It probably swam through
there.
Oh, it did. Huh. Smoke up on top of that mountain.
Yeah, probably a fire.
Did you see it up there, Wells?
Uh-huh.
The fog and stuff coming out of the treetops?
Yeah, it's probably a fire.
No, there ain't no fire, honey. Just how the mountains are. Now that one up there is a fire. I still can't believe this road's 60 mile an hour. It's as close to an interstate as you can get. You think they'll have any foolers here you like, Wells? You might confine your future whip to ride around on. You gonna give Willow yours?
I might get
the other one. If I find
one with a little
seat back
on it,
yeah,
I'm gonna take off the seat.
I didn't do it. They decided to bow up on me. Good thing I just got some brakes put on here. We might have bought a Fusion Titanium Edition. You trade your Wagoneer for that?
Yeah. Do that.
Right, here we are. Oh, they got boats and everything here, Wells.
Uh-huh. They even have bell things?
Have what?
Right.
Yeah, we can look at boats. Looks like they do Line X.
Andy's boat can even drive.
Yeah, we got quite a bit of pretty equipment out here.
Look at that.
What are you talking about, that little Cub Cadet with the bagger on it? You need one of them?
Yeah.
I see they sell Bobcat. Let's find out where we need to park at. I'm guessing right here in the middle. About as good as it gets. Let's go inside. So here's you guys, a regular edition that is, I don't know, I know that's aftermarket wheels and tires, which are beadlocks, and those are legit beadlocks. But man, these are such a good looking machine. I'm excited to see that metallic color in person. Oh man, it's one sweet ride. I cannot wait to try one of these out. I mean, it reminds me so much of a General. I like this rack back here. I might have to get one of those for mine. You got some big tired XPs over there. What does that got on it? 35. My goodness. Video doesn't do that any justice. I bet that thing sounds like a roaring lion going down the road. How you doing?
Good, how are you?
You Kevin?
I'm Kevin.
Hey, but it's good to meet you. Sorry, I got my whole family with us and stuff. Is that the ride over here?
That's the ride.
Okay, good deal. I'm excited to see it. We made it a little faster than what I thought I was going to.
Hey, you made good time.
Oh, yeah, man. My wife's always like, if this says 3 hours, we're going to be there in two.
Now, where is that
two? Right here it is, buddy. I love the color. I seen a green one over there. Both of them look really good. I wouldn't have thought the green looked as good in person, but it's actually a really good looking color. This is it. We had a 22 Polaris Northstar Ultimate in that same, that matte color. And we really liked it, which it didn't have, you know, it was this color on the, it didn't have as much paint as they do now. But we're excited to try this out. What do you think? What's your thoughts? Oh, it don't matter. Okay. No, we're good, man. All right, well, let's go get it. I guess if you're ready, we'll go get everything ready to go and get it taken care of.
Have you seen this one, how you open it up up here?
What? Yeah, you got to take the front clips out and then pop the hood up. Okay. Yeah, I've watched a few videos on it. I watched a release on it. And, I mean, I've studied about everything there is to study on them. I just haven't been able to get my hands on one, man. I've been trying forever. We pre-ordered one, and the dealership got one in, but they just keep pushing mine back, keep pushing it back. And I seen this online. I was like, I got to snatch this up while I'm able to.
Well, I got people mad at me.
Well, sorry.
You know what? We had two of these.
Really?
I sold the one, just the other one just left, and I sold it too.
Really? You know what? Well,
they were held. And then they didn't sell, so our manager said, they're open now. So I posted a thing.
Right.
And I guess you saw it.
Oh, yeah.
Both you and somebody else hit me up this week. And I was like, sure, come on.
Well, I mean, that's the thing. You know, even back home, we've got three really good dealerships that legitimately will sell them for the price that they are without tacking on thousands of fees. Yeah. And I've never paid a fee one whenever we bought all of our. I don't know if you check the channel out or not. But I just try to tell people, I'm like, man, if these dealerships are tacking on thousands of fees, you're going to be upside down before you even get it out the door. And I was like, that's not where you want to be at. And if someone wants to pay them and they're that desperate to get one, so be it. But I'm not in that ball game. And so Wells, quit, honey. You're going to hit you.
I like the bucket seat.
Don't open that door. Stay right there.
I feel like a little Jeep.
You go out the other side. No, you go out the other side over. Go out the other side, honey.
No, I like the bucket seat.
Yeah, I like it too. But anyway, let's get in here and get his part ready to go, and that way he's got all his paperwork done. So here's this one, and I'm going to have him pull it over by the green one so you guys can see both colors, and maybe it'll help you decide on which color you would choose if you was going to buy one of these units. Still can't get over how big those tires are. I mean, my goodness. So you can see the green one over here, but we're going to put them side by side. This one's decked out. So there's the green, and there's the silver. I think it's called matte metallic. I like the matte metallic, although the green does look really good. I'll let you guys see what you think. So there they are side by side. And it's kind of hard to tell with the sun, so we'll get a side view of both of them so you can see them here. There's the colors side by side. Which one do you like better? I still like the silver better. The green's good looking, but I still like the silver. But which one do you like?
I like that one.
Do you? I do too. I think it. What I really like about the blue, and I haven't heard anybody talk about this, but you get colored springs. Your interior's got the scents in it that are blue. Whereas,
I'm on the green team.
Oh, you like the green? She's always opposing me. Like she always likes the opposite of me. But no, I really like that rack there too.
Yeah, they added the racks and stuff on there. They wanted to show people what you could do on it.
Is this a specific package?
No, it's just the racks they put with this new system they have.
Yeah.
So this is the new, how it fits on there, this new stuff they've got on there.
Man, it slides in there and works perfect. And it's,
what do you do with the rack?
Like, well, I mean, this rack, you can use it for tires, coolers, anything you want. But basically, this extends your bed. So if you've got dogs and stuff back there, you can give it more room. So if you put your coolers here and tie it to this, then your dog's still got that whole bedroom or anything.
It defeats
the purpose of the dump bed. I mean, that comes on and off in a matter of no time. All that stuff pops off there. It's on that new rack system. And what do you think about that, Wells?
I don't think it goes down.
You don't think it goes down? You think it's stuck like that?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I guess we'll get it loaded up. So there you guys go. There's a green one, and there's the color we picked. I'm glad that we've seen this. I was looking at this rail here before I left, but look, this is busted on our unit. See it right there?
Mm-hmm, Daddy.
It's cracked. They're going to see if they got one in there. But I'm glad that I looked that over. That's why it's super important to check these machines out before you take them, just to make sure that you've got all the stuff and it's working properly. Well, get in there. What do you think of it? You excited?
Yeah.
Don't pull that out of neutral, honey. That's how, see, these ain't like the Defenders. The only way the parking brake works is if you've got it in P. If you pull it out of P, that thing love will take off with you. You've been sitting here running, what, 3 or 4 minutes? So it's probably 18.2, 18.3 at 154.2 miles. I can't believe that camera's busted. Hopefully they've got one here. So I wanted to give a shout out to this dealership because they had two of these Expedition units, and mine had the broken cameras I just showed you guys. They're literally going to take it off of another unit and put it on mine to fix mine. And I mean, I don't have to wait or nothing. I mean, I got to wait for them to put it on, but that's huge for dealerships to do that. You know, take it off one unit and just put it on yours so you've got a good one. A lot of time it has to do with stock and stuff, but this is Knoxville Power Sports, and they literally charge me zero fees. I mean, zero. So that's huge. If you guys are around this area, you may want to deal with them. I dealt with Kevin, super cool guy, seemed like really nice. But we'll be back to get the unit in a minute. We're going to go eat while they're fixing it. I'm excited to get it home tested.
While fixing the side-by-side, this guy recommended to come down here to Carolina Ale and eat. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to see what it tastes like.
Are you excited? Hey, what are you doing? Come on, little man. Alright, so we're almost home, thank the Lord. And we went 300, basically 31 miles, and got 14.7 miles per gallon average down and back. It's a little bit dusky out, but just looking at the outside of this, I mean, I absolutely love the look of these. I do think they're going to have some blind spots, as I mentioned, but from a design standpoint, I think that they've got placement of everything really well. This is a little funky looking to me, the air duct that goes into the clutch system. I'm not sure what these odd chambers hanging down there are for, but they're there. Like I said, I don't know if that's for dust or what. But I love the color and the shock color and stuff on there. The doors are nice. They've got a really good
click and feel to them. Got some locks on there. Huge plus. You getting around strapped?
Yeah.
All right. These guys were troopers on the way down. Wasn't you, Willow? Just cried just a little bitty bit. You were such a good girl. Yes, you were. You're such a good girl. So driving this thing around, I love the ergonomics of it. I mean, I'm not going to lie. It feels like you're in a little race truck. And the screen setup, the layout of the buttons, just the lights in it and everything at night, how it rides, I mean, it's as smooth as you're going to get. I mean, if you're looking at one of these compared to a Ranger or a Defender, it's no comparison as far as ride quality. But the thing that really stands out to me is how the gear is in it. So when you're driving it, I was in high. And when you're driving it in high, it feels like you're in low gear the whole time. It just has this very grounded gear feeling to it. Like I said, almost as if you're in low all the time. As far as peppiness and how fast it is, I don't know that it's would beat a Defender racing, but we're going to find out. So you guys just stay around, and I'll give you some more impressions tomorrow, kind of let you know what I think about it. But other than that, I mean, it's a really sweet machine. And this sound system is so far above anything that I've heard in a side-by-side from the factory yet. Air conditioning seems fine. I don't notice that it's any better or any worse than our Defender. But other than that, I love the automatic windows. That's a huge step up, so you can roll all four down from up here. And then you've got them in the back that are automatic too. And you've got the two cup holders there. The seats feel good. At first I was kind of worried about the position and how it would sit, but I kind of like it. It's a little bit different, kind of switch things up. It's got an extremely bright dome light. So we're riding around in low right now, and we're running about 7 to 8 mile an hour.
Hey, I can't feel
you can't get yourself buckled? Here, I'll help you. There you go, hon. All right, so just idling, it sits at about 1,250 RPM, 1,300. But in low, if you're going anywhere over 4 or 5 mile an hour, it's really loud in low, but it's also geared to the ground. The low in this is probably 2 times lower than what it is in the Can-Am Defender. Now, it seems extremely peppy when you're driving it, and I'm going to show you here, I'll let you kind of hear what it sounds like. But I'm going to get my watch up and show you guys on the app what its decibel reading at just idling. So right now, that's just idle. When I talk, you can see it go up. So let's ride around here and see what we get. Let's just turn the air on one. So we've got that noise and we've got the engine noise. Let's see what we got. So about 66. All right, let's ride around and see what we get. You see how much louder it is when it's going, but also look how peppy this is. I mean, it's got quite a bit of pep in low end. I mean, it'll sling the rear end around easy. High to me feels like what I would ride around in all the time. I don't know. I guess if you rock crawl and stuff,
you would need low. But for me, it's just a extremely low gear. I think we'll see how it is on the trails. I'm kind of excited to see what it does there. But to me, I would just leave it in high all the time. And now we're in high. So let's see what it is in high idling. So we're gonna ride around in high, and I'm gonna show you what how it does in high. So there it is in high. We're running about 11 mile an hour. It's at about 4,000 RPM at 11 mile an hour. And we'll cruise around the field. The shock package on this is so impressive. I mean, things that I was hitting in the Defender that it would buck you in the seat, you don't get that at all in this. It has zero body roll, and it's extremely, well, it may have a little body roll, but as far as it pressing the impact that you hit on the ground, it doesn't do that with this. Tomorrow we'll really test it out, but there's some initial thoughts on it.